When I work on these sacred geometry stones, they take me a couple of days to paint. And the reason why is, first, with this big plumpy dot, I let it dry before I even attempt this first row because these dots are so tiny and I have to try to get my spacing as close to perfect as possible because the whole pattern builds off of those first couple of rows. Then once I get to the sides, I have to wait for all those dots on top to be dry so that I can hold it so I can position the stone to place these dots on the bottom. And then once all the dots are dry, I can go in and add these teeny tiny detail dots.
Lay it down, but don't push. All right, let's do it. Y'all ready? Oh, that's kind of cool, actually. I'm kind of digging this. Link in the bio, baby.
For the next experiment in our crystal growing adventure, I'm going to attempt to grow some crystals just by pulling them off of the surface. This seems to be a very common method when you use a lot of bismuth, but it can be rather hard to nail down. I got very lucky, and this is my first cooling. You can see it's just barely hardened on the top, and I have this chunk right here. I don't know if it's crystals, but when I pull it out, I can see it's got depth. And boy, is it a crystal. It's another super detailed one, and I let it cool extremely fast, which gave it the dark blue look you're seeing here. I made this heater coil to get the edge of the bismuth molten out of this Walmart hot plate, and it seems to be working all right. We're starting to get somewhere with the colors. Absolutely gorgeous. I threw these ones into the toaster oven real quick, which gives me this rainbow look. But now I need to figure out what I did before, because I can't get this to work anymore. Thanks for watching.
Let's talk about the most powerful artist in the world, Ai Weiwei. This is the piece that got him arrested and beaten up so bad by the police that he had to get brain surgery in Munich. Basically, there was a huge earthquake in Sichuan in 2008. It killed 90,000 people and thousands of school kids. And the government tried to cover it up by not releasing names, being very hush-hush. So Ai Weiwei goes over there, takes 150 tons that literally crushed the people who died, straightened them up one by one, and lined them up to depict the fault line schools were built on. It should have never happened because the government should have either not built them there or build safer buildings. Also, when he was there, he went around Sichuan to get all the names of the people who died, which his team was arrested for. But he represented all the names of the people he could get as a part of the exhibition. It basically commemorates the dead and criticizes the government for trying to cover it up and not taking responsibility for what happened. He continues to criticize the acts of the Chinese government and bring light to the situation and to other human rights issues across the world. He also just has cool stuff.
Sleeping in a cardboard box, spending every dollar at the liquor shop. And even though I know I haven't got a lot, I try to give you love until the day I drop.
It's about damn time. In a minute, I'ma need a sentimental man or woman to pump me up. See if I see you walking in my bed. See if he's trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give a fuck way so much. I'ma need like two shots in my cup. Wanna get up, wanna get down.
Said I would never fall unless it's you I fall into.
And the seasons change, who is there but me? The sun and your man built the fall.
Don't want to hear my brain.
I'm sitting in the corner with a pile full of laundry. I don't really wanna do it, but nobody'll do it for me. And I can't find the socks there.
Oh.
You want a taste of my brain? Okay, it's yours anyway. I'll buy the my high. Alright, I wanna put up a fight. How about today? You try eating someone else for a change. Because the way they
I'm
Sometimes your words just hypnotize me.
Baby, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways.
We even got a secret handshake. And they like the music that my band makes. I know I'm young, but if I had to choose them or the sun, I'd be one nocturnal son of a gun. Take a look at my boo thing. They're the only one I got. Ba-da-da-da-da. Yeah, I'm loving mine, bitch.
Oh, so be die. Go, go, go.
Got it. Some guests.
I'd like to see you wiggle, wiggle, for sure. It makes me want to dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet two in a compact, no slack. But luckily the seats go back and got a knack to relax. In my mind, I'm sipping some red, red wine.
Today, in the continuation of our crystal growing adventure, I'm going to attempt to grow some nice dark blue crystals. But just wait till the end, because I wasn't expecting at all what I'm about to get out of this batch. And in case you're new here, this is bismuth. Never heard of it? Well, you actually have, as it's the main active ingredient in Pepto-Bismol. In order to get blue crystals, you want to cool them down as fast as you can. As the cooling process causes the multicolors in a spectrum much like a rainbow. And after taking it outside quickly and waving it around in the wind, this is what I got. I could not believe my eyes when I saw this huge pyramid in the middle, and look at the rich blue. I had to be very careful to get this out as I didn't want to break that pyramid. And after busting everything up, this is what we got. It's mostly blue and gold, which is definitely acceptable. If you find this material as beautiful as I do, feel free to drop a like and a follow, as these crystals are just going to get crazier and crazier as I learn. Thanks for watching till the end.
How to paint clouds with acrylic paint. Today you'll need violet blue, cerulean blue, titanium white, and water. Start by mixing all three hues to create a gorgeous sky color. Then take away some of that sky color and mix it in with more violet blue. I recommend stopping and making sure that they are the same value by using a black and white filter. They should look like the same value of gray next to one another. Using a wet brush, go ahead and softly outline the edges of your clouds. Reference photos are encouraged. Also add your horizon line. Go ahead and use that sky color to fill in your background. As you get closer to the horizon line, you want to mix in a little bit of white to help make the value lighter. It should be lightest at the very edge of your horizon line to create an illusion of atmosphere. Using your sky color mixed with violet blue, go ahead and fill in some of those shadow shapes in your cloud structure, leaving the edges white. Now we're going to use a technique with watered down paint and a dry scumbling brush to push those edges into the sky really gently. We want to create that illusion of fluffy edges and form within our sky. pay attention to your reference photo and slowly build these values and transitions. After everything is rendered, go in with a wet brush and your sky color to help soften those edges. You want your clouds to look like they're pushing gently up against the sky, not an abrupt line in between the cloud edge and the background. Clouds are wispy and will not have any hard edges within them. After that, I go ahead and fill in my ground with a gradient from green to sky blue. For more atmospheric perspective, take that same super light blue and blur the line between the sky and the ground. With a wet, flat brush, take that same super light blue and go ahead and add some streaky clouds in the background. The water in the paint should make it easy to blend with your fingers, which will create a nice, wispy, faraway look, like the same stratus clouds we see in the sky, creating a special level of depth. Lastly, if you want, you can go ahead and go in and add some extra little fluffy clouds in the foreground, just to add some extra visual interest to your sky. Thank you guys so much for watching.